In this video, we'll see how to create a square wave of 50% duty cycle on bit 0 of the port 1 and similarly 66% duty cycle on bit 3 of the port 1 without timers. So here 50% duty cycle means on period and off period should be same. To find out the duty cycle, we have the formula, that is T on divided by T on plus T off. So if we use that formula, we get T on is equal to T off. We'll see that with the help of the compiler. So first, square wave means we have only two values, that is 1 and 0. So in this one we are using port bit 0 of port 1 to create a square wave. So we need to send 1 and 0 alternatively to bit 0 of the port 1 with a small delay. So first we'll set the bit of port, which is bit port pin 0 of the port 1, and then we'll call the delay. Again we'll set now 0th pin of, we'll clear 0th bit of port 0 and then we'll call delay. Yes, jump again to repeat the code. We need using short jump and it will start from here. So we'll write the delay subroutine. We'll load R1 with 255. We'll repeat this instruction for 255 times. That is the JNZ R1 comma repeat, and that should come here. So always the last instruction of the subroutine should be written. So now we'll see this. So here let us open we'll close this. To see the waveform we can make use of logic analyzer window. So this is the logic analyzer window. First we need to set up, means which port we are using, that we need to add to the logic analyzer. So here we are using P1.0. So let it be display type bit. Close this and now run the program. So now we can see here both on period and off period are same. both on period and off period are so same, so this give the 50% duty cycle waveform. So next we'll see the 66% duty cycle is nothing but the on period should be 2 times of the off period. So this can be calculated using the duty cycle. So that is duty cycle equal to T on divided by T on plus T off. In place of duty cycle, if you need to substitute 66%, that is 0.66, that time you will get T on will be equal to 2 times of the T off. So for that, just now in this program you can see after setting the 0th pin of P1 we are called the delay. In these cases between on period and off period the delay is same. So to get the on period 2 times of the off period we'll call the delay again. So again I got some problem in the compiler, just wait for 2 minutes. Let me reinstall the Keel compiler. So like this, for any duty cycle we can create a square wave without timers. So any port we can make use. In this example we have seen only the we have taken use of only one pin of the port P1. If you want we can make use of all the pins of the particular port. So that time we need to send 0FFH to port and after that we need to send 00H to port, that so we get on period and the off period. Let us open again Keel compiler. So this program is for 66% duty cycle. So we'll execute this. So now we'll set up. We'll close this and again I'll give fresh one, that is P1.0. Wait, close this and now run. See, now you can see here that the on period is 2 times of the off period. So I hope it is clear. So the on period is 2 times of the off period. So this is all regarding the module 3, that here we have seen what are subroutines, what happens when the subroutines are executed, and how to program the ports of how to program the ports of 8051, and how to generate a square wave, and how to make use of ports as an input port and the output ports. And in the next we'll see some other program which uses the subroutine not for generating the delay but to do the frequent task. So for that we'll take the example, this one, that is write an ALP to convert packed BCD number stored in the extra memory 400H to ASCII number and store the result in extra memory 401H onwards. So in this case we need to convert packed BCD into ASCII value. So the procedure is to convert packed BCD into ASCII is, first we need to separate packed BCD should be converted to unpacked BCD, that is 29H should be separated as 02H and 09H, and then 30 should be added to the each bit. So here adding 30 is the same task for those two values. So we can make use of subroutine to do the task of adding 30H to unpacked BCD numbers. So in this program, the subroutine is doing the task of adding 30 to A. So first, according to this program, first DPTR is loading with 400H, that is the memory of the external external memory location where the data is stored. And then we are getting the data to accumulator, and that data we are moving into R0. So now here we need to separate our BCD value. For that we need to mask the first value. So for that we can make use of the instruction AND with accumulator, with that is 0F0H. So if we AND the given data with 0F0H, the LSB will be masked and we get only MSB. So that is, in this case, in 29, if we do with that, we get only 2 and 9 will be masked. But in this case, when we mask this value, we get 20, but we need 2. So that's why we are swapping accumulator. So when we swap, LSB will come to the MSB place, and like lower nibble will come to the higher nibble place, and higher nibble will come to the lower nibble place. So next, for this 2 we need to add 30H to convert that value into ASCII, and for that we are calling the subroutine, that is call sub. The name of the subroutine is sub. So what we are doing here, it is just we are adding 30 to accumulator and then we are returning to the main program. So after that again we are incrementing the DPTR and we are storing the first converted ASCII value in the next memory location. And next again we are getting the original data into accumulator, and now we are masking the 0F is nothing but it is, we are masking the higher nibble. So then again after that one we need to call sub protein called sub. So next here, when this instruction is executed, it will call subroutine program, and then it will add the TH and the data will be stored again back in the DPTR. So we'll see this example now. Again, same problem with this. Let me wait for 2 minutes. Let me reinstall the software. So like this, we can use the subroutine for any task which we need to do very frequently in any application. So now we can conclude that for the subroutines, there are mainly two advantages. One is to create a delay, and another one is to you do the task which needs to be performed frequently in the frequently in any application. Let me open the software. Sorry. Open the project, open the old project itself. So now we'll execute this. Okay, so now first we need to store the data in external memory, which is in 40H. So let us consider the data as 29. So now we will start executing step by step. So here you can see DPTR initially it is 000H. Now this will be loaded with 400H. And next we are accessing the data from 400H to accumulator, and we got 29. And next we are moving the same data into R0 because later we need the same data. And next we are masking the lower nibble, so we got accumulator is 20, but we want this 2 in the lower nibble place, so we are swapping accumulator, so we got 02. And next we need to convert this value into ASCII value, so we are calling the subroutine which will add 30H to A. So now you can see now when it is called the subroutine, the program counter is loaded with the address of the 16th instruction, and the address is 0013, and similar the address of the instruction which is present below the subroutine, call subroutine, is 000A, means that value should be stored in the stack. Let us check whether it is stored in the stack pointer or not. So by default, stack pointer location will start from 07H. See, we have 000A, that is the address of the instruction which is present below the subroutine. So now the control is in the subroutine. See, now accumulator is become 32H, means earlier it was 02H and that is added with 30H, and now control again is back to the instruction which is present below the call instruction. So next again we are getting the So here this value should be stored in the 401H, and for that we are incrementing the DPTR. So now DPTR is 401, and now we can see here in 401H we have the ASCII value of the 2. And same way next it is converting 9. After calling delay again we are getting the control is in subroutine program. So we got 39 and that value is stored in this case. So like this we can write the subroutine for anything which we want to do it very frequently, so that we can save the time. So many people can write subroutine in the different places, and later we can combine all those things to get the single application. So that is the advantage of the subroutine. Thank you.